guys, it's Judy here with My Life as Geek Eye. On this channel, I create videos on product reviews, makeup tutorials, and lifestyle advice with the aim to entertain, educate, and enrich the lives of others. So if you're new here, please consider subscribing. I would love for you to join the Geek Eye family. And if you're returning here to my channel, then welcome back. Today's video is going to be a somewhat like a makeup tutorial of this look that I have going on right here. This look was inspired by Olivia Valance's cha-cha routine in Dancing with the Stars. Now, I know that that routine was performed a few weeks back now. It's probably like two performances ago, but I was very much inspired by the makeup look that she had going on for that dance routine. I believe this makeup look was created by Martin Bray. I will leave his Instagram linked in the description box down below. So all credits go to the makeup artist who actually created the look that Olivia was wearing. If you live in Australia, you know that Dancing with the Stars is on Channel 10, I think. At the moment, I don't watch television, but I have seen bits and pieces of Dancing with the Stars. And while I don't care about all the other contestants on Dancing with the Stars, I am quite keen on following Olympia and Jared Brenz's journey through Dancing with the Stars. So for this look today, I used the Juvia's Place Duche eyeshadow palette. I used some colors in here and mixed in a few other colors from the James Charles's eyeshadow palette. I just used some of the pinks and then a little touch of the purple and some of this shimmery blue shade here. But majority of the shadows I used were in the Juvia's Place Duche eyeshadow palette today. So yeah. If you want to see how I created this Olivia Valance's cha-cha routine on Dancing with the Stars and makeup look, then just keep on watching. Before I go any further, if you guys enjoy my videos, then please be sure to give this one a thumbs up and subscribe before you leave if you haven't already. I put new videos out every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, so you can turn on the notification bell if you don't want to miss any of those future uploads. You can also follow me on my social media, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. All of them are Life as Geek Eye. And without further ado, let's just get straight into this makeup tutorial. Before I start, you guys, can you please excuse all the texture and lumps and bumps and breakouts that I have going on my face? I was waiting for my skin to clear before I started filming, but if I waited for my skin to clear, I think I might be waiting a few months and I'm not gonna have any videos to put up for you guys. You'll just have to bear with my disgusting looking skin at the moment. So much for all the skincare. Sometimes stress just gets the better of you and it takes it out on your skin. So. Yeah, there's that.
First, I'm going to prime my eyelids with a L'Oreal Infallible 24-Hour Concealer Pomade. And then going into the Duche eyeshadow palette, I'm going to be taking the shade Berry Mousse and blending this out into my transition to set down that concealer. Now I'm going to take the shade Creme and blend this out into my transition. I'm just going to blend that shade absolutely everywhere to give myself a seamless transition. Now taking the shade Puffs and a fluffy blending brush, I'm going to blend this out into my transition and above my crease. As a general rule of thumb, you don't usually blend shimmery shades out into the transition, but this is what the look called for, which is why I did it. Now I'm going to be taking that shade Custard and blending this out on the outer corners of my eye. I'm taking it up slightly into my crease as well and into my transition. Next, taking my BH Cosmetics Eyelight in the shade Gnarly, I'm going to be now applying this all over my eyelid. I found that this particular formula needed a bit of building up, so I applied a layer, let it dry, and went over the top again with another layer to achieve the desired opacity. Now I'm going to go into the James Charles eyeshadow palette and picking up that shade Hello, I'm just applying this over the top of that BH Cosmetics eyelight. Now I'm going to be taking that shade Custard again and mixing it with the shade Creme and blending this out on the outer corners of my eyes. I found that it fluffed off a fair bit of that eyelight, so it didn't build up together very well. So I picked up some of that shade Single and Skip from the James Charles eyeshadow palette, mixed them together and used that to blend out the outer corners of my eyes, just to build up the intensity of the color. I'm reapplying some of that shade Hello from the James Charles eyeshadow palette, just so that I don't lose some of that blue on the outer corners of my eye as well. I'm building up the purple on the outer corner of my eye again. There was a lot of going back and forth with these shades. Now I'm taking the shade Tarte and blending out that shimmery shadow all over my upper lid, under my brow, just to build up the shimmery look that Olympia's look really sported. Next, I'm taking that shade Puffs and blending this out under my brow. And taking some of the shade custard, I'm again building up the intensity of the purple on the outer corner of my eye just to give myself a little bit more shape and dimension. I'm taking some of that shade macarons from the Duce palette on my finger and building this up on the outer corner of my eye as well. Now taking a makeup wipe, I'm just cleaning up all the fallout under the eyes and giving myself the sharp wing look. To prime my face, I'm using the Mecca Cosmetica Smoothing Primer, and I really need this smoothing primer because of all the texture that I have going on my face at the moment. And for foundation, I'm using the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation. I absolutely love that the way this foundation blends out on my face, but I find that it doesn't wear very well on my skin. After a few hours of wear time, the texture on my skin really shows through, so I don't think I'll be using this foundation anymore, not unless I'm only planning on wearing it for a few hours. Next, I'm taking my Models Prefer Contour Stick and using this to give my face some depth and dimension. Really trying to give myself the illusion of having cheekbones here. Blending all of that in with my Morphe Beauty Sponge. For contour powder, I am taking my BYS Contour Trio palette and taking the contour shade in that palette. I'm using this to further build up the illusion of having cheekbones. For highlight and concealer, I'm going to be using my Maybelline Age Rewind Concealer, applying this under the eyes, on the forehead, and down the nose. And again, blending all of this in with my Morphe Beauty Sponge. Next, I'm going to bake with my RCMA Translucent No Color Powder, and I'm going to bake quite liberally under the eyes and under the jawline. Now I'm going to go in with the ColourPop Cream Gel Eyeliner. I'm not quite sure what the shade is, but it's really just a plain white eyeliner, and applying this in my waterline. Now I'm going to be taking that shade Custer on a fine detailed blending brush, and I'm going to be blending this shade all out under my lower lash line, and again taking the shade Creme with a fluffier blending brush, and I'm going to blend this shade out all over the lower lash line, and doing the same again with the shade Custard. Now I'm going to be taking some of that shade Tarte and using this to further highlight the look on the outer corners of my eye, and again building up that purple shade on the outer corner of my eye with my finger. Now I'm going to be going in off camera with some eyeliner, mascara, and false lashes. For blush, I'm going to be taking my Saharan Blush Volume 2 palette by Juvia's Place and taking the two shimmery shades in the middle. I'm further applying some of this shimmery highlight blush on my cheeks. For a bit more highlight, I'm going to be taking the Milani Strobe Light highlighter and further highlighting my face with that. For some of that intense inner corner highlight, I'm going to be taking the NYX Shimmer Stick in the shade Platinum and applying this on the inner corners of my eyes and then blending it out with a fluffy blending brush. For lips, I'm going to be taking the ColourPop Satin Liquid Lipstick in the shade November. And then over the top of that, for a little bit of extra pop of color, I'm going to be using the Ofra Cosmetics Long Lasting Liquid Lipstick in the shade Wonderland. Now for the bling in this look, I'm going to be taking just some of this plain glitter filigree rhinestone things that I have. I don't have any proper face festival sort of diamante stickers, so I just went in with this and I cut the little bits one by one and applied them all around my eyes, as you will see. I thought it was quite cute and fun, actually. And just because I didn't think I had enough highlight, I again went in with that shade Tarte from the Duce eyeshadow palette and further highlighted my face with this. Really love the color shift that this shade has.
So this is the completed look, you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Sorry, my hair is a little bit ratchet. So yeah, my hair never ever does anything pretty or nice. I have it tied up here. I'm probably gonna get told that it looks not very nice, but anyway, I already know it doesn't look very nice. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, then please be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe before you leave if you haven't already. I do put new videos out every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, so you can turn on the notification bell if you don't want to miss any of those future uploads. You can also follow me on my social media, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. All of them are Life is Geek Guy. Let me know if you enjoy this sort of makeup tutorial, like looks inspired by music videos, celebrities, different makeup artists on Instagram. Tag me in any makeup look on Instagram if you'd like to see me recreate it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate that you've chosen to spend your time here with me today. Thanks again, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye. So all credits going to the actual artist of this makeup look. So basically, that's all I have to say. The Juvia's Place Duche eyeshadow palette I used. So for this look today, I used the... Duche and mixed in a few other... And some of this short that I have going on my... I've been doing. Sometimes stress just gets the better of you.